Hey everybody, welcome to PBI Radio and another edition of The Boxing Pulse. Joining me is my man, Eliud Vasquez Torres, also a PBI Radio. And we are about to be joined by Charles Whitaker, who fights tomorrow night against Gabriel Rosado. Should be a good fight. It's going to be on NBC Sports Net. And let's welcome Charles Whitaker. Charles Whitaker. How you doing, man? I appreciate your time. Big fight
coming
up.
Thank you.
Big fight coming up tomorrow night. Gabe Rosado. Tell me about it. What do you think of Gabe Rosado?
When I see him, he's a young kid, crude, and you know, he comes forward, not a whole lot of anything special. I mean, he just does what he does.
Mhm. And
what he does, and
So, what are you expecting from out of the fight? How you think you're going to do? What's your plan?
Go ahead.
What's your plan to fight him?
My plan to fight him and win. You know? That's my plan to fight him. I mean, I don't know what he's going to do. I'm going to see what... I made no plans about anything other than to win. And I prepared myself. Well, I've seen him, in different fights where he does... Looks like he's a little different each time. So I don't know what he do with one guy doesn't mean everything to do with me. So I'm gonna see what he comes out and do. I'm prepared for anything.
Mm-hmm. And what do you think of when did you get here for the fight? How long were you here for?
Tuesday.
Mm-hmm. Go on, Ilya. You got questions?
Yes, Charles. This is a big fight coming up. It's an IBF eliminator. Has it set in yet that if you are victorious, you're gonna get a world title shot? Right after. What do you think about that?
Well, I'm happy, I'm grateful to God for all his blessings because, it's been a long road and it's God who has cleared the path for me and has blessed me and allowed me to be able to still be able to do what I love to do most in the world, and I'm just looking forward to a good fight and I'm looking forward to being victorious.
And like you said, it's been a long road. You turned pro in 1993, and you had some early losses in your career, but you turned it around. How do you turn around after losing three in a row or five in a row? How do you turn it around and keep improving like that after all those years? What did you learn from those losses?
I learned a lot from those losses. I learned that that even in those losses, I learned that I was a winner and that I could get up. And, anybody in life could be knocked down. And being knocked down is not what counts. I mean, they said Thomas Edison tried over 400 times to prove that he could get electricity to work. He got it right once, but he failed 400 times.
And tell me about boxing in the Cayman Islands. What did you notice about? Did you popularize it more so? You're the most popular guy.
Absolutely. I've much more popularized boxing in the Cayman Islands. I mean, without me doing what I'm doing, sport wouldn't be where it's at. And Cayman government has built a multi-million dollar facility, and we hired a proper trainer and got somebody in there to help our local coach and be. Developed the program, and we got amateurs who are doing well. A couple of other kids who are looking forward to turning on to the professional scene. So, I promoted, Knocker Productions promoted a number of shows over there in the last few years. So, we have brought a number of American fighters over. We've given opportunities to others, So we've done some good things. I'm proud of what we've been able to do. I'm very proud and just grateful to God for what he has blessed me to be able to do with what I've had to work with. I've gotten this far not because I had a lot of money behind me or I had any big name promoters backing me up. I've had to work for everything. I mean, we've had to push Raul and myself and the rest of the Knocker Productions team, Coach Norman Wilson and my sister Shanette and Annie and my baby Marie. We just have to push to make this all happen and my family and other people close to me will help to make things happen, and we've just been blessed.
Yeah. So you're working on the after the boxing career is over and the business aspect of it. You're working on promoting now and everything.
Well, I've Yeah, but I started promoting way back in 1997, you know, so because I realized the route I had to go. I started promoting back in 1997, and I stopped for a while, and I realized that, you know, turn things around, but I realized waiting around, and being at the mercy of somebody wasn't going to get it done for me, and, you know, we went ahead and started promoting other shows. I mean, just trying to make things happen, and, you know, I guess we did something right. We're here now.
That's right. It's all panning out right now. Elliot, take it.
Yes. Yeah, you mentioned, you know, being from the Caribbean and the Cayman Islands. How special was it for you to win the Caribbean Boxing Federation title in front of your people in there in Cayman Islands?
Well, you know, it's good. I mean, it's good to be victorious anywhere, you know what I mean? But, of course, it was good to be able to do it at home. But,